Hi friends, so this is part 2 of the video about the interim reliefs sought by Lodha and Justice Gautam Patel's order in that respect. Just to recap, the interim relief sought by Lodha was basically to shut me up completely so that I am not able to say a word about any Lodha project or any matter concerning Lodha. No videos, no blogs, nothing. That was more or less, to sum it up, those were the prayers. Now, then this was sought as interim relief before the case actually goes to trial. To actually prove defamation is an uphill task. I don't have to tell you that there are videos which are probably running to 8 to 10 hours of video on Lodha alone. We got about 4 feature films, that kind of a length of videos if we add them all up. A huge number of videos. There are about over 200 videos in my YouTube channel. The bulk of my channel consists of Lodha related videos. So to review all of them, to watch them, to parse the various images and the words and say this is defamatory, this is not defamatory and so on, is a Herculean task that awaits the judiciary as and when it chooses to take it up. I am told it will, just for going to trial, any defamation case may take 6 years, 10 years, 20 years even. I am told that cases in the early filed in 2000 are not yet being heard in year 2019. So the queue is very long. Needless to say, we will not be, the case will not be heard for a reasonably long time. So in the meanwhile, they wanted this interim relief that the High Court has to ask me to shut up, basically. That is it. Now, Justice Gautam Patel asked some very, very sharp questions, very incisive kind of hearings were held where the Lodha senior counsel was completely put on the defensive. So for about 2.5-3 hours on 24th of April, the questioning was so intense. Maybe it was not 2.5-3 hours, maybe around 2 hours. The questioning was so intense that at the end of it, he seems to have come to a decision to bring it down to 5 specific statements. And so, these are the 5 statements that I am not supposed to say. That was their prayer, and that has also been rejected. So the 5 proposed statements where they sought injunction. Statement number 1. The suited booted residents of Lodha New Cuffe Parade have been conned into living on a construction site, and MMRDA officials who issued the certificate are in connivance. It is an open secret hiding in plain sight. It is the proverbial elephant in the room. So Justice Gautam Patel asked me what I had to say about this, and I said I stood by this statement. And then he said, well, but do you have any proof of this? And I have mentioned in another video that indeed I had proof at hand. I've always had the proof on my mobile, but thanks to a very happy accident, I actually had the proof printed out and it was in my hands which I showed to Justice Gautam Patel. There were RTI applications that indicated that Lodha was hiding the details of the permissions, or rather the background details behind the occupation certificate. And there were also documents, letters written by MMRDA, which said clearly that Part OC had been given subject to Lodha completing, or rather on the condition that Lodha will complete the internal works. So this means that occupation certificate, even partial occupation certificate was given by MMRDA when Lodha New Cuffe Parade was not fit for occupation, was not fit for human inhabitation. This much was very clear. And the papers came out so clearly that Justice Gautam Patel was completely convinced. So this was they have taken from my blog post titled Lodha NCP Residents, Where Are Your Recreational Open Spaces? And they had made that an exhibit. I was able to reply to that. So here is what Justice Gautam Patel says. This is part of Rao's blog post on 9th January 2019. The statement that Mr. Jagtiani says is offending is in the last paragraph. Rao is emphatic that he stands by this statement. This means that in the law, it is incumbent on Lodha to demonstrate that this statement is per se defamatory. I will turn to a discussion of law presently, but it seems to me that this statement does not fall within that definition. It is undoubtedly comment. Some say that it is aggressively worded, but that is possibly the worst that can be said about it. See, when you make fair comment, there is a defense against defamation, which is called making fair comment. Now, if it is a reasonable comment that one makes on anything, any proceeding, and any activity, and moreover activity which is public in nature, then it cannot be said to be defamatory. So one may say something about Modi or Rahul Gandhi, and one may say things like Modi is a feku or Rahul Gandhi is a pappu, but that constitutes comment. It cannot be said to be something worse than that. So in this way, this is the defense that this is what Justice Gautam Patel is saying. It is not without factual context to claim that it should be read in isolation without its preceding paragraphs is as unfair as it is untenable. So again, these statements that are made are within a context. There is a whole article there. You can just Google the heading and read that article. The preceding four paragraphs make it clear that according to Rao, and he claims he is in a position to justify and demonstrate this, a local or a special planning authority has granted permission for occupation of a structure that is nowhere near ready or fit for occupation. Now, I have the letter, I have the documents for this, and I am going to actually make a video of these documents. It is, he says, risky. The allegation of connivance in the last paragraph is a conclusion that he believes he can legitimately draw, for he questions how any authority could lawfully have granted such occupancy certificate, complete or partial, for a project so far from readiness. The occupancy certificate, the part occupancy certificate, came sometime in 2017, I believe. We are now in 2019. We are approaching mid-2019. The project is not yet complete, and not only the towers which have been given part OC, but all the towers that are there, that entire campus consisting of I think 8 towers, everything is a construction site. The whole place is a construction site. So I completely stand by it. There are no recreational spaces worth naming other than the club and some small pockets. I have said there is no place, you know, you can walk your dog. There is no real open space where you can run or jog or kids can play. No open air where kids can play cricket and so on and so forth. So I stand by my statement. Anyway, this was the order. Now, so Justice Gautam Patel says, I will therefore not grant the injunction that Mr. Jagtiani seeks in respect of statement number 1. Now coming to statement number 2. It is a large plot of land that has been leased from MMRDA which has been originally intended for infrastructure. Very honestly, there has been a lot of golmaal in the way they have acquired the plot. in the way MMRDA has leased them the plot. Okay, in the way they have acquired the plot, in the way MMRDA has leased them the plot. And this comes to us from a video titled Lodha Defamation Case Against Us for Criticizing New Cuffe Parade Wadala. Rao states he has sources. Now these are observations of Justice Gautam Patel. Rao states he has sources to establish the correctness of what he has said here. In fairness, he agrees that the factual material is not disclosed or stated in this paragraph. He agrees that he will not repeat the statement without the necessary factual basis. So, if I don't get any further information in terms of what I said about the plot of land on which New Cuffe Parade stands, then I will not repeat it. Okay? I will not elaborate on this statement, or I will not repeat this statement, but I expect to lay my hands on the documents to substantiate this statement, because I have sources, and therefore once I have those documents in hand, then yes, I will not only state it, but I will expand it. So Justice Gautam Patel says he agrees he will not repeat the statement without the necessary factual basis. I accept that statement, but clarify that this is not to be construed as a requirement that he must reveal his sources, nor an assessment of the sufficiency of this factual material. His statement is only to this limited purpose, that without supporting factual material, this statement at page 30 and culled out in this form will not be repeated hereafter. Rao's statement is noted and accepted. Now, statement 3 of 5. The third statement. That said, it does not mean that they can make a product without following rules and norms, National Building Code and DC regulations. Various norms for designing a building have been thrown to the winds. Now, they have culled out this statement, and there are parts of it which have been excluded. That's what those dots are. I'm not getting into what exactly those things are, but it comes from the transcript of a video titled Lodha Defamation Case Against Us for Criticizing Lodha New Cuffe Parade Wadala. So it comes from the video where I have talked about the defamation case itself. Okay? Again, this is part of the same written transcript as statement number 2. The extract is only partial. I reproduce the whole of it. Now, this is Justice Gupte reproducing the whole of it. Justice Patel, I'm sorry. That said, it does not mean they can play with the lives of people, and does not mean that they can make a product which is shoddy or ill-conceived without due process and without following rules and norms, National Building Code and DC regulations, that we have to keep quiet just so that their brand identity does not suffer. I do not believe this, and I am not going to stand for it. How any court is going to see things, quite honestly, that is a state of affairs that I would oppose, even at the cost of committing contempt of court. Now, this statement, as you guys can understand, is a direct transcript of a statement I made in this video, where I was basically talking about the defamation case against us, and I was briefing the public about the defamation case filed against us. That's why you see that there's a lack of grammar in many places. So the second part of it is, I say this with full consciousness of the seriousness of what I'm saying. I like to believe that the judiciary of our country is not going to throw the common man to the dogs. I would like to believe that the judiciary is there to uphold the quality of life, the rules, the laws, the norms, the standard practices that have been established, and is not going to stand by as builders violate these norms and rules and standard practices and throw them to the winds. This was the complete quote. Now, I will leave aside the Justice Gautam Patel is saying, I will leave aside the second portion, which is an expression of Rao's expectation of the judiciary. The first portion is what affects Lodha. The allegation here is that there has been a violation of rules, norms, the National Building Code and DC regulations. It is true that this has been stated in generalized terms without particulars. Rao says, as he did for the previous comment, that he reserves to himself the right to show particulars of these violations, and that if he agrees not to make a generalized statement hereinafter, it is with that express reservation and qualification. Indeed, Rao states that as regard to Thard's and Jaisingh's flat, there is a previous architect's report which points out specific violations. That report has been included in his affidavit in reply from page 363. That is a report of Nadkarni and Company, a firm on this court's panel. The report is of 7th January 2019. It was commissioned by Jaisingh. The report does say that there are violations of the National Building Code and DC regulations, but does not say which. It does point to a very specific carpet area deficit. The accuracy and correctness of this earlier report are disputed. Mr. Haryani for Lodha, that is the advocate for Lodha, also submits that it is not sufficiently specific to substantiate what the defendants have said. Yes, the architect has said that there is breach of DC regulations and National Building Code, but he has not specified which DC regulations and which code violations are there. So Justice Patel says that submission is noted. Now, this reminds me, guys, I need to make a video of, as I said, the specifics. I told the court on that day that I actually had in the pipeline a video coming with specific violations of National Building Code, and that is true. An expert, a drywall expert, has helped me identify specific code violations which greatly endanger the building, DRO, and probably other buildings also, which form fire safety norm breaches, and I am going to make videos on that. As for the exact violation of DC regulations, I will also be making videos on that. So yes, this is, but without such specifics, I will not make a general allegation. Now, Justice Patel observes, it is difficult to accept Mr. Jagtiani's statement that the statement is per se defamatory. It will have to await trial. There is some material supporting justification. There is no law that demands that at an interim stage, a defendant in such an action must prove all his justifying evidence. So I got justifying evidence. I will be able to present more of it later on. Consequently, there can be no injunction of the nature that is sought in regard to the third extract, which means no gag order. As far as this third thing is concerned, I am basically free to say what I want in this respect. The fourth statement. Banks are part of the Lodha scam. No, this is, yeah, statement 4 of 5. Banks are part of the Lodha scam. Banks are also involved with Lodha in passing of loan. That is because, now these are unconnected sentences coming from a transcript of a video that I made while I was fasting. This is because Lodha is such a big customer of the banks that Lodha dictates terms to the banks. Banks have an approved project finance form, and mostly normal builders who are there have to fill up that bank form. Okay, approved project finance is APF. That's the short form of approved project finance. But over here, it is completely opposite. Over here, that is in Lodha case, the APF form is made by Lodha and banks fill it up. Banks take this kind of risk because Lodha is giving them bulk business. They, that is Lodha, also tend to dominate them, that is banks. If any bank says we will not fill up your APF form, you fill up our APF form, then Lodha will tell them we will not recommend your bank. We will tell our clients not to go to your bank. So in this way, there are a couple of banks which are blacklisted by Lodha. HDFC Bank have got the bulk of the home loans of Lodha. They are hand in glove with them and are protecting them. This was my statement. A video titled How Banks Are Part of the Lodha Scam. Now, this is not part of the plaint. This is part of the rejoinder to Rao's affidavit in reply. They have extracted this from a rejoinder to my affidavit in reply. This extract is from a video that is at least partly in Hindi. It's all of it is in Hindi actually. The offending portion is scattered all over this transcript. Rao is accused of having said this without justification that banks are also involved with Lodha regarding the manner in which loans are passed. Lodha dictates terms to the banks. It is a large customer that banks cannot refuse. Banks have an approved project finance form. Most have to fill up the bank mandated form. But in this case, it is Lodha that does so because Lodha sends bulk business to the bank. If there is any protest, then Lodha does not recommend the home purchase financing from that bank. One particular bank is mentioned and it is alleged that it is in cahoots with Lodha. Now, these are the observations of Justice Patel. The context has nothing at all to do with mere financing or even the level of influence or money muscle, but is traceable to an allegation Mr. Rao makes that the entire financing structure is based on an incorrect statement of the actual carpet area of the flats being sold. This overlaps what was being said in the previous extract. In addition, there are incorrect representations as to the phases or stages of construction and their date of completion. He illustrates this by saying that the area mentioned supposedly includes balconies. Mr. Jagtiani's response is that this is something to which the purchasers have agreed in their purchase documents. Okay, Mr. Jagtiani's response that this is something to which the purchasers have agreed in their purchase documents is underwhelming, and that is putting it mildly. You see Justice Gautam Patel's humor here, you know, is underwhelming, and that is putting it mildly. What Rao says is that financing is obtained on the basis of a carpet area representation Lodha knows to be inflated and incorrect. This homegrown definition of carpet area as including balconies and perhaps flower beds is a statement of fact. That is indeed how the carpet area has been computed. Okay, this is what Justice Gupta is saying. This homegrown definition of carpet area as including balconies and perhaps flower beds is a statement of fact. That is indeed how the carpet area has been computed. Whether this is lawful or not, and if not, why this has been done, is an opinion and falls squarely in the realm of fair comment. Therefore, when Mr. Jagtiani says that this is per se defamatory, he throws down the gauntlet, meaning he gives a challenge. He challenges Rao to show that any part of it is true. Once Rao does this, and there is now supporting material from Nadkarni's report, it is for Mr. Jagtiani to show that the allegation is without a vestige of truth and that it was always so and that Rao never had a basis for his statement. He cannot. He cannot. And so, I have not even turned to Rao for his view. Meaning that the very argument that these guys have made is simply knocked off its pedestal by Justice Gautam Patel. On an objective assessment, I find that what Rao has said here is an opinion, fair comment or argument with some basis in fact. There is no question of an injunction or even of asking if he will volunteer a statement. So I am completely free. In other words, when it comes to this statement on banks and how they are in cahoots, Justice Gautam Patel finds all justification, and I am completely free to say anything I like in this respect. There is no injunction. Then Justice Patel continues, Lodha may or may not like the word, the use of the word scam. Courts are not here to pander to Lodha's notions of exquisite linguistic delicacy. If indeed there is this carpet area misstatement in the agreement itself, and obviously that statement was presented by Lodha with purchasers having no say in the matter, then there may be a storm coming with other far harsher words looming on the horizon. That statement is not prima facie per se defamatory. So what Justice Gautam Patel is saying is, बॉस अभी तक इतना ही बोला है, इससे बहुत ज्यादा बोल सकते हैं. तो ये जो बोला है ना, वो डिफेमेशन नहीं है. दैट इज बेसिकली व्हाट ही इज सेइंग. नाउ द फिफ्थ स्टेटमेंट, आई एम गोइंग टू एंड दिस वीडियो आफ्टर द फिफ्थ स्टेटमेंट, ओके, एंड लेट अस पुट द रेस्ट ऑफ इट इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो. The basement of Lodha New Cuffe Parade does not have occupation certificate. The fire brigade has not inspected it. MMRDA has not inspected it. MMRDA will not certify it. It cannot be certified as it stands. This is what I said in a video. I suspect that in the space where they had permission for 3 basements, they have gone and built 4 basements on the top of it to cut corners and maximize their basement space, and now they do not have enough head space left for proper air circulation, and that is a chronic problem. That is not a problem that Lodha can fix. I am sorry to give you the bad news, guys. Many parts of Lodha New Cuffe Parade is an unfixable problem. It is a ticking time bomb, and the authorities need to take note of it. The hazard is that in the basements, the fire systems are not in place, that the ventilation is not in place, and there is no scope for ventilation. Now, this is contained in the video titled Lodha NCP Basements Are Ticking Time Bomb. Mumbai Fire Brigade, you have been warned. And they extracted this from a transcript. This allegation is in relation to an occupation certificate. The relevant portion must be approached with some caution. Rao is accused of saying that the basement of this entire complex does not have an occupation certificate. The fire brigade and MMRDA have not inspected it, and it cannot be certified as it stands. He alleges that with permissions for 3 basements, 4 were constructed. He also alleges importantly that the clearance or headspace is inadequate for proper air circulation or ventilation. He says this is a problem that cannot now be fixed since the construction is done. He says this is a fire hazard with inadequate provision for ventilation. Rao maintains the underlying factual basis. He says it is inconceivable that any occupation certificate or any form of certification of fitness for the purpose could ever have existed to such basements. It may be that there now exists some form of certification. That would not mean the underlying deficiencies do not exist. The issuance of a certificate is a fact, but it does not postulate the correctness or lawfulness of the issuance of that certificate. He believes that no such occupation certificate for the basements, full or partial, could in these factual circumstances ever have been granted. He maintains that it constitutes a safety, fire and health hazard. He has a somewhat colorful description of it, but I will let that pass. He does not say that there is enough clear space. He does say that there is not enough clear space for the exhaust or extractor fans to draw polluted air. In some cases, he has himself seen the vents or circulators are blocked by beams and structural elements, as also pipes and other civil works preventing proper air flow. The carbon monoxide sensors are not calibrated. All always show only zero. Now Justice Gautam Patel says, how is it possible to say that this statement is per se defamatory? I am not assessing whether Rao is able to prove his statements. The test is whether he claims justification. He does. And whether he is able to demonstrate even prima facie that such a state of affairs exists. On what does he base this? He says he has himself seen all this. He knows firsthand of these conditions. He says that while he may himself not be an expert, he was accompanied by one such person who was, but whose name he cannot reveal. He therefore maintains that this was based first on material he himself saw, but he does not rest at that. He not only wrote about it, he videographed it. He took photographs of it. There is therefore contemporaneous documentation that he asserts in justification of what he says in this context. For this statement too, no injunction can be granted. Friends, I will stop with this, and the next video will have more about the remaining part of this order.